Ryan, today is the day I get the honor to call you my husband. You are more than everything I've ever asked for. How lucky am I to have you? I'm the happiest girl alive with you, but most importantly, I know anything is possible with you. Thank you for all you have given me and that all you've done for us. Our love is everlasting. Wherever you are, I'll follow. Know that I will forever be by your side, and you'll never be alone. I hope these gifts are a small token of my love. Always and forever, your soon-to-be wife.
To my bride, we have gone through so many firsts together. Our first date, our first kiss, our first vacation, the first time we told each other I love you. I cannot wait to see you for the first time in your dress and look forward to a lifetime of more firsts for us. I love you, my angel, Ryan.
No! If you look about this great lawn, you'll readily see what a remarkable gathering we are. You've traveled from near and far, and you come from so many different times, places, moments in the lives of Ryan and Victoria. And in gathering here on this cool spring night, we form a tapestry of love. And it's with that love that we embrace the two of you. Victoria, Ryan, all you have to do is just turn around, look out, be brave, and you'll see that tonight you are totally surrounded by love. And I say, revel in every moment. As we enter now into this time of thanksgiving and blessing, this time of renewal and commitment, I invite each of you to put aside all the cares and concerns of this week and simply rest. Rest in the beauty of this time and place. We gather in love. Allow yourselves to be renewed and refreshed by that love. Ryan and Victoria have invited Ryan's dad, Jim, to gift us with a reading.
I think this says a lot about these two lovebirds. When he looked into her eyes, he learned the most important part of the language the world spoke, the language that everyone on earth was capable of understanding in their hearts. It was love, something older than humanity, more ancient than the deserts. What the boy felt, Ryan, that moment was in the presence of the only woman, Victoria, in his life, and with that, with no need for words, she recognized the same thing. Because when you know the language, it's easy to understand that someone in the world awaits you, whether it's in the middle of the desert or in some city. And when two such people encounter each other, the past and the future become unimportant. There is only that moment and the incredible uncertainty or certainty that everyone under the sun has been written by one hand only. It is that hand that evokes love and creates the twin soul for every person in the world. Without such love, one's dreams would have no meaning. Good luck.
A poet once wrote to his beloved these words. He wrote, "When you and I first met, the meeting was over very shortly. It was nothing. But now, it is growing into something. And what it makes of me all the days of my life, that is the real meeting. The other was just the beginning." Well, Victoria, Ryan, we all come here tonight grateful for that first fateful meeting at Worcester's Garden. And we are grateful for all the meetings and adventures, the twists and turns that eventually brought you to Una Notte in Italia. And with a yes, it brought you to this moment in time. And so tonight is a wonderful night for so many reasons. And most especially, tonight is a night for wishing and hoping. And as you all party away the night, each of you will have an opportunity to embrace Victoria and Ryan with your hopes and wishes. Well, I too come here with a wish of my own and offer it in the hope that it echoes what's in your hearts. So, Ryan, Victoria, I now remind you that marriage begins in the giving of your word. You cannot give yourself over to the other without giving your word. And this giving must be unconditional. For in giving yourself over to the other, you give yourself over to the mystery of life and love. And so it is now. We, your family and friends, with open hearts, bear witness as you give your word, which is your life, to each other.
Although I'd lived 35 years before we met, I can hardly remember what life was like without you. I truly believe that fate brought us together from opposite ends of the country, completely different backgrounds. Somehow we took long and winding paths to find each other. We met at the perfect time, the perfect moment, or we may never have even crossed paths. As I stand before you, you're the culmination of a dream come true for me. I have found my equal, my soulmate, my best friend, and my favorite person in the world. Today I will marry you, the one I will live with, dream with, and love forever. From this day forward, I promise to make everything an adventure, or food venture. I promise to hold you close every night and never let us lose our spark. I promise to share my food with you, even though you said you weren't hungry, but then ate half my food. I promise to be more patient with you, to wait in long lines, even though that's the thing I hate most in this world. I promise to never forget this is a once-in-a-lifetime love, and to always know that no matter what challenges may carry us apart, something will always bring us back together. I promise to love you as much as I love our puppy, Callie, and stop calling you 1A and 1B. But most important, I promise to be the husband you deserve and never stop doing the little things that got us where we are. I love you.
Are you going to hold it?
Yeah.
Hey, to my groom, Ryan, the day has come. Can you believe it? Never did I ever imagine to even step in a place like Pelican Hill. But here we are, here I am, getting married to the man of my dreams. Today is not about you or I. It is rather a celebration of us as we partake in this journey together. Someone once told me we accept the love that we think we deserve. And I just want to thank you for giving me that never-ending, unconditional, and genuine love. Thank you for being you, the kindest man, the one who gives and gives but never expects anything in return, the one who goes above and beyond to make me happy, the one who works endless hours to give us not just a house, but a home, the one that makes me whole and the one that God has given me to spend the rest of my life with. I am the luckiest woman because it is such a privilege to be loved by a man like you. You once told me that I saved you. But what you didn't realize is that you saved me. I was broken and lost until you came along. You are my peace, my savior. You have changed my life in ways you will never know. And you will never know how much that means to me. I promise to seek a deep understanding of your wishes, desires, and your fears and dreams. I promise to offer forgiveness each and every day and never go to bed angry. I promise that you will never face any problems alone, as I will always be by your side. I promise to respect, admire, and appreciate for who you are, as well as the person you wish to become. I promise to support you, love you, but above all else, not yell at you just because I'm hungry. I promise that I'll try my best to stop stealing your French fries and spicy ketchup. I will always fight for your love, even if it means if I have to compete with Callie, our dog. I vow to always honor you and cherish you for the rest of our lives. You are my soulmate, the person who I never knew I needed, my best friend, my teammate, and I am your number one fan. If you win, I win. We both win. I loved you yesterday, and I can't imagine
loving you more than I do in this very moment, but I know somehow I will even love you more tomorrow. We are forever bonded today as one. I cannot wait to grow old with you, and I cannot wait to be your wife. I love you.
Ryan, Victoria, you have spoken from your hearts. You have pledged your word and your life to each other, and I say, so be it. Victoria, Ryan, as you hold hands, I remind you that these are the hands of your best friend. Young, strong, and full of love for you. These are the hands that will wipe away tears, tears of joy and sorrow. These are the hands that will give you strength in time of need, that will tenderly hold your family as one. And these are the hands, even when aged, will still reach out to you with the same touch that comforts you this night. Ryan, Victoria, whenever you glance on these rings, know that you are loved beyond all imagining.
Give you this ring as a sign of my love.
I give you this ring as a sign of my love.
I give you this ring as a sign of my love.
Please stand. So, truth be told, life, in all of its glory, doesn't get any sweeter than this moment in time. Victoria, Ryan, we all thank you for the gift of tonight, because tonight you remind us life is good and worthy of our best. And so with grateful hearts, we bid you both and pray God. May the blessing of light be with you always, light without and light within. May the sun shine upon you and warm your hearts until they glow like a great fire, so that all who know you may feel the warmth of your love for each other. And may God ever gracious grant you peace, peace in your hearts, peace in your home, peace in your united lives, indeed peace unto eternity. And now, by the power vested in me, it is my honor and my sweet delight to pronounce as and to present for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Ryan Bass. Now you may kiss.
Live. coming in first, everybody, are your bridesmaids and maid of honor. Let's hear from everybody.
Break it down, speed it up. Now slow that down on the gas. Slow it down. Bust it, bust it, bust down. Bust it, bust it, bust down on the gas. Oh, bust down, Tatiana. Bust down, Tatiana.
You already know what tonight's going to be like.
Bust down, pick it up.
Your groomsmen and best man, let's hear from everybody! Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure and honor to introduce you, Mr. and Mrs. Ryan Bell!
Everything that don't make sense about me makes sense when I'm with you. Like everything that's green, girl, I need you. But it's more than one and one makes two. So put aside the math and the logic of it. Gotta know you want it too. Cause I wanna wrap you up, wanna kiss your lips. I wanna make you feel wanted. And I wanna call you mine, wanna hold your hand forever and never let you forget it. Yeah, I wanna.
Put your hands together, everybody. Applause, everybody. Don't expect a free ride
from me. I just wish you guys the best of everything life has to offer. I'm so thankful that you're in my life. I'm so glad that you brought Callie into my life. I just want to make sure that you know that everyone that is here tonight wants to be here for you, wants to be here for you guys, and that we wouldn't want to be anywhere else right now. So cheers to the amazing couple. I'm sorry I couldn't read my speech because I would just cry too much.
Love you.
Cheers.
Love you.
Give me a hug. Love you.
So to tie it all back together here, the spice to the chicken soup is the way of keeping things interesting, continuing to appreciate the meals that V provides, and continuing to live life together, not in a bland way, but always adding spice to your life. So for all of you, can you please raise your glasses with me?